Students, we have been given a problem here to obtain the Fourier transform of f of x is equal to e power minus a squared into x squared, where a is always greater than 0. Once again, the problem is obtain the Fourier transform of f of x is equal to e power minus a squared into x squared, where a is always greater than 0. So that prove that e power minus x squared by 2 is self-reciprocal under Fourier transform. F of x is equal to, we know that the Fourier transform of f of x is written as f of x is equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity f of x into e power I s x into dx. Here f of x is e power minus a squared into x squared. Therefore f of e power minus a squared into x squared will be equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity. In the place of f of x, we shall now substitute e power minus a squared into x squared. So e power minus a squared into x squared into e power I s x into dx. This will be equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity. Now e power minus a squared x squared into e power ISX can be combined as e power minus a squared x squared plus ix, and this will be equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity. Let you take the minus sign outside in the e power, so it is e power minus of a squared x squared minus ISX into dx. Let us go for some algebraic manipulations to achieve our results. We know that b minus c whole squared is equal to b squared minus 2bc plus c squared. From this, we can arrive that moving c squared to the left hand side, b minus c the whole squared minus c squared will be equal to b squared minus 2bc. And let you assume b is equal to a into x and 2bc is equal to isx. From this, we can write that for 2bc, 2 into b is a into x and c is substituted as it is. 2 into a into x into c will be equal to isx. From this, we can arrive 2a into xc is equal to isx. From this, we can find out a substitution for c. C is equal to is divided by 2a. Because x and x will be getting cancelled each other, therefore c is equal to is divided by 2a. Now we have taken an expression underlined by dotted lines, b squared minus 2bc is equal to b minus c the whole squared is equal to c squared. Now from b squared minus 2bc is equal to b minus c the whole squared minus c squared, this can be written as, let you substitute for b squared, b squared, b is ax, so it is ax the whole square minus 2bc has already been assumed as isx, so minus isx is equal to b minus c the whole square. B is ax, c is, we have found out that is by 2a, so a minus x, a minus, sorry, a into x minus is by 2a the whole square minus c squared is is by 2a the whole square. Now you look into the left hand side. The left hand side is a squared expanding ax the whole squared. It will become a squared x squared minus isx is equal to ax minus is divided by 2a the whole squared expanding squared. So is will become I squared s squared. I squared is minus 1. Minus of minus will become plus. So it has become a squared at the denominator. 2a the whole squared is 4a squared. So a squared divided by 4a squared. Let this be marked as equation number B. Now students may confuse themselves why we are going for these kind of steps. And when you are seeing the final steps of the problems, you will understand why we have taken these steps. Because this is a very complicated problem and we have to find out the Fourier transform of f of x is equal to e power minus a squared into x squared. We can find out in any form, but our duty is from the final steps of the Fourier transform of f of x, that is f of e power minus a squared x squared, we have to prove that e power minus x squared is self-reciprocal under the Fourier transform. So that we have assumed all these steps and we have arrived a substitution for a squared x squared minus isx. And this will be substituted in further steps, and let us go towards the final proof of the problem. Now the equation number A here, it is rewritten. It is arrived by the conventional steps. The Fourier transform of e power minus a squared into x squared is equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus pi to plus pi e power minus of a squared x squared minus isx into dx. And we have found out a substitution for a squared x squared minus isx as a into x minus is divided by 2a the whole squared plus s squared divided by 4a squared. Now we are having two equations, one is A and another one is B, and B is a substitution, and let you substitute B in A. Using B in A we shall get the left hand side will be equal to Fourier transform of e power minus a squared x squared will be equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi. Let you go for the substitution. Integral of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus of a squared x squared minus isx is substituted by a term a minus is by 2a the whole squared by plus a squared by 4a squared into dx. Let you understand this step very clearly. This is a substitutional step. We have substituted for minus of a squared x squared minus isx, and this will be equal to 1 divided by square root of 2 pi integration of minus infinity to plus infinity. Let you expand into two terms e power minus of ax minus is divided by 2a the whole squared into e power of minus a squared by 4a squared into dx. Let this be equation C. And you can take, we are integrating with respect to x, so e power of minus s squared divided by 4 squared can be taken outside of the integral, and this term 1 divided by square root of 2 pi e power of minus a squared divided by 4 a squared e power of minus s squared divided by 4 a squared has been taken outside. The other terms are written as integral of minus infinity to plus infinity e power of minus ax minus is divided by 2a the whole squared into dx. Now to solve this problem, as usual procedural steps, t is equal to a into x minus is divided by 2a, and differentiate the left hand side, it is dt, the right hand side is equal to a into dx, the differentiation of is divided by 2a, and when x is equal to minus infinity, t will also be equal to minus infinity. When x is equal to plus infinity, t will also be equal to plus infinity. Now let you substitute the values in the equation number d. And equation number become by square root of 2 pi e power minus s squared by 4 integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power of minus of ax minus is by 2a will be written as t. So it is e power of minus t squared, and dx can be written as dt by a, and a can be taken outside of the integral. So the integral as 1 divided by a into square root of 2 pi e power of minus s squared divided by 4 a squared. This is a constant term which has been taken outside of the integral, and the original integral is integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus t squared into dt. And let you use another tool to get the value minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus t squared. And we know from the integration formulas, integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus x squared into dx is equal to square root of pi. And this is having a similarity with the integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus t squared into dt. So this term, integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus t squared into dt, can be replaced by square root of pi. The answer is 1 divided by a into square root of 2 pi e power of minus s squared by 4 a squared. The other term, integration of minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus t squared into dt, has been replaced by square root of pi. And from this step, we have arrived the Fourier transform of e power of minus a squared into x squared is equal to 1 divided by a into square root square root of 2 into e power minus s squared by a squared. And as per the problem, from this step we have e power of minus a squared by 2 is reciprocal of we have to prove that e power of minus x squared by 2 is reciprocal under Fourier transform. Proved that Fourier transform of e power of minus a squared into x squared is equal to 1 divided by a into square root of 2 e power of minus s squared by 4 a squared. Let this be equation x. This is what the proof we have arrived. From this proof, we have to show that e power of minus s squared by 2 is self-reciprocal under Fourier transform. Now, we have the left-hand side and we have the right-hand side. And put a is equal to 1 by square root of 2, both on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. At the final step, we shall be able to prove that e power of minus s squared by 2 is self-reciprocal under Fourier transform. Now, put a is equal to 1 by square root of 2 in x. The left-hand side will become f of e power of minus, in the place of a, we have substituted 1 by square root of 2 the whole square into x square is equal to, at the right hand side, we have 1 divided by a into square root 2. So 1 divided by a has been substituted as 1 divided by square root 2 into minus s squared is taken as it is, 4 is taken as it is, and a squared is written as 1 divided by square root of the whole square. Now, let you reduce, and e power of minus of 1 by square root of whole square will become, when it is squared, it will become 1 by 2 into x square. Minus sign is there, so it is f of e power of minus x square by 2. At the right hand side, the square root of 2 will get cancelled with the square of 2. Square root of 2 at the denominator, e power of minus s squared is taken as it is, and at the denominator 4 into, and squaring 1 by square root of 2 will become 1 by 2, and 4 into 1 by 2 at the denominator it will become 2, and it is e power of minus s squared by 2. You already know that if the Fourier transform of f of x is equal to f of s, Fourier transform of f of x is equal to f of s, the given function f of s is a self-reciprocal under the Fourier transform. Now we have proved f of e x squared by 2 is equal to e power of minus s squared by 2. So this is of the form Fourier transform of f of x is equal to f of s model. So e power minus x squared by 2 is a self-reciprocal under Fourier transform.